Today's episode of the Captain's Blog is brought to you by Merle's Towing Service. I want to thank the awesome guys at Merle's for coming out today and helping us tow our tow truck. They're donating their services to get this move so that we can get the brakes fixed on the tow truck, and we are deeply grateful to the crew at Merle's, so thank you guys for helping out with that.
Merle's and Grand Rapids Towing, if I'm not mistaken. You guys
yeah.
are...
Yeah, one of the same.
One in the
it's
same.
It's all same company.
Okay.
This Mergers. Is Mike. Hi, Mike.
Hi.
I'm Chris. Welcome to the Geek Group, sir.
Good to meet you, buddy.
And the gentleman at Lens is Mike, who's going to be helping us.
So it's a Mike days, huh?
The day of Mike's.
This is cool. I like Mike's. Hey, bug our Mike.
I bugged him yesterday, but yeah.
Okay.
I haven't heard. I think he had an appointment today.
Okay.
And tomorrow. And then tomorrow his parents were going to take him boating.
Oh, cool. All
yeah.
right.
So that was the only.
That's
my
a hell of a tow truck. That's a hell of a tow truck.
I've been told by that before.
Yeah, but you drove giant army trucks.
No, I mean when I drove a civilian box truck.
Oh. It was
a 16-footer, but I rolled it over a snowbank on the side of the road.
They
brought the rotator, put a belt around the thing.
That's fun.
Good morning.
Doing well.
Howdy, sir. Another fun-filled day?
Yeah.
What are you up to?
I wanted to take a picture of the truck getting on the rig.
Oh, sure. Go ahead.
They work with my company.
Oh, cool. Okay. Yeah, come. Have fun. Do whatever you like.
Picture and illustrate to my team what a heavy duty tow looks like.
This is a heavy duty tow. This is fun.
So I can take a couple pictures.
You take all the pictures you want.
I've been inside too, man. I got my membership.
Cool. Well, welcome to the weird. Oh shit.
I've been doing some woodwork and stuff.
Cool. This is about to get interesting. There's a lot going on here.
He's gonna
swing out and back in, and
yep.
He's gonna take it from the back, not the front.
Safer that way.
Really?
You damage the transmission if you leave the axle stuck.
Oh, okay. How do you keep the front wheels from turning?
Usually the steering wheel will lock. Otherwise, he's got goodies.
Okay.
If the steering wheel doesn't manually lock, he shouldn't have straps and ratchets. And that
okay.
sort of thing.
That car's in about the worst possible spot.
Actually, Ed was here and Jerry was immediately on the other side, so
okay.
They weren't doing real well either.
Yeah, but we could move those cars. We don't have keys for that?
I don't know if it's locked.
Whenever anybody who's working on a car leaves it in the lot, make sure you have a key and the ability to move that car and get written permission to move it. Get with Moose, create a form and a policy so that if somebody... Exactly because of
this
shit like this.
Yeah.
This is why. Because he's a really cool guy, but right now I'd really like to move that car. Not as much as Mike would like to move that car.
I think Mike can move that car.
I have no doubt, but I have a feeling there would be unpleasantness if he did.
We're not at all familiar with unpleasantness.
No, never had that before.
Sound good.
I'm having one of those moments in my life where I don't know what the hell you're doing, but I'm pretty sure you do, so it's all right.
I'm just learning as I go here.
Okay, well, we're used to that.
There you go.
That I can handle.
Nothing wrong with that, right?
You ever done a fire truck before?
Oh, yeah. Yep.
Cool.
You betcha.
Oh, wow. Just so you know, sir, you now have career envy of every 12-year-old boy in America. It works on radio control.
You bet.
Oh, that's cool as hell.
You betcha.
That's neat. Appreciate your helping us. You guys made a hell of a difference.
Take care now.
All right, you have fun. Goes our fire truck, headed for its very long 2-block journey up the road. So the fire truck's heading out so they can fix the brake bleeders. The brake bleeders are old and rusted solid, and Jesse's just having trouble with them rounding off, so we're gonna take them up to Lenz's and they're gonna get those replaced, and then we can get the fire truck back in service, which would be pretty cool. Wow, bad parking spot. Sorry about your sign, Praxis. Nope, he made it. Even the dogs are excited. Well, there's one you don't see every day. That's kind of cool. All right, so welcome to today's Captain's Blog. It's 10 a.m. Thursday, July 21st. What? Hey. The sausage dog is back.
Hi.
Good morning, campers. Welcome to today's Captain's Blog. It's 10 a.m. on Thursday, July 21st, 2016. Ed's here. We just shot the cool bit of video with the fire truck. That was fun. So now
it's time for me to be awesome.
Hey, if you haven't added me on Facebook, because I do a lot of stuff on Facebook that doesn't make it in the blog, you should do that. Find my personal Facebook. It's not hard. And there's just read everything I've written in the past 48 hours. It's kind of cool. We're doing a lot of really cool local stuff in the community, and it's pretty neat. So go check that out. In the meantime, I gotta go get the world moving. All right, so time is 10:15 hours. I gotta get over here because you're backlit. Okay. So tell them who you are and what you do.
My name is Chai Benedict. I'm from West Grand Neighborhood Organization. I'm the crime prevention organizer, and I'm also a community engagement specialist, and I'm here dropping off water for the Gate Group's cooling shelter.
Cool. And it just made MLive. So I'm expecting, and so you brought some water, and we brought some water, and we're all set for a ton of people.
And we, the executive director, Annette Vandenberg, she is also making calls to try and get more water for
Excellent. Me. That's a good idea. So who are these gentlemen that have come to help you?
These are my sons. This is Liam and this is Aiden. And they are helping me haul water today.
Well, that's awesome. All right. We're going to get that cold and we're ready for people.
All right.
So cool. Thank you.
Thank you.
You are awesome.
Yep. Have a good day.
Have fun.
Yeah.
12:15 hours. Ed's rocking out. What you got going on here?
I am moving the projector mount back by the beam so I can try to fill that window.
Cool. So this is Ed's project. We're working on being able to display projected images onto the front windows. Just for fun. We have a bunch of projectors to play with, so why not? Fire truck back. I gotta make some phone calls and sort out things with the fire truck so that we can charge the tank, and not just once but like a lot, because I want to be I want to do a thing for neighborhood kids, because it's like 300 degrees outside this week, so I want to be able to have the fire truck going a lot, and we need to be able to charge off a hydrant. So Sausage dog! How you doing? You're such a good puppy. Yeah. Batman's fixing my radio. So I'm upgrading to a metal one, huh?
Yeah.
They clip on much nicer on the belts anyway.
I'm cool with that.
You just have deeper. Okay. Weird.
You gotta use the old screws.
Yeah. You have a longer, deeper holes, I guess, whatever. So longer screws it is. Fine, be that way.
Holes are different sizes? Or different locations?
Location.
Oh, sorry. Yeah. What? God! It's so hard being you. This dog needs love, Batman. So I gotta have the original one? Hole spacing's different?
I actually know what to do. It's just drilling a hole, probably. Just off by a little bit.
Put the plastic one under for now. Just fix the pin.
Puppy!
Hi. How you doing?
Go see him.
Puppy!
Come here.
Hi. He doesn't have any cookies. No. Neither do I. But I bring the love. Yes. So, you gotta tell people who this dog is and why she's here.
This is Echo. This is my sister's dog. My sister is out of town for the week, and I'm the one she usually calls to house sit or puppy sit the dog. So I puppy sit the dog.
Yay!
She listens to me. Yeah,
she's a good dog.
It's all because I let her sleep on the bed, too.
Yeah. This dog is made for cuddles. Made for cuddles. Yes. Totally freaks out the cat. And the dog doesn't give a shit about the cat at all. I think this is wildly entertaining. I'm a horrible person. I'll be back.
We have a...
Yeah, the sky is going a little green out there.
Tornadoes! Woo!
I like tornadoes. Tornadoes are fun.
We can get a new roof. We have a new roof.
We just got a new roof.
I swear to God. The roof.
So, Batman.
I say things like this.
This is the Shrike. It's a little experimental quad I'm working on. Okay.
Holy
so that's the package, right?
It's
and
horrible.
It's a quad. Yeah.
Wearing it.
Why?
Oh, Jesus.
What? Oh, hey, the fun's... All right. Batman?
Yeah?
Calling all hands, storm prep, car windows, roof stuff, whatever. Fun's coming. Hey, Ed.
Yeah.
Quadcopter kits,
so,
right?
Okay. If a wreck... Yeah.
No, read it out loud.
Okay.
We shut down the road.
Why?
It's awesome.
But he showed us how to do it now, so I know how to do it. That's mine.
Hey, go over there a moment.
I was like, man.
Stop. Turn around. Quadcopter kit?
Yeah.
Okay.
Come help me with the window on the Jeep.
I'm working on it. At least tape it up or something.
Yeah. So you might enjoy this.
What?
Guess what this is. I got it. I figured it out.
Planets.
Yes.
All of them.
It's kind of neat. Now, if you curve it, it could be one of those neat little bangle things.
See.
And now that's stuck in my head.
Well, what are they sitting on?
The sun.
Yep. Two scale. Everything.
That's cool. So if we were to continue the circle, then...
There we are.
A little tiny, little...
They're back from the sun. Yeah, they're in order.
Mercury's barely there.
Yeah, it's just it looks like you can flick it off. That's cool.
Megan.
Huh?
I gotta show you something funny. This is a quadcopter kit, so it's a little thing that flies, right?
Right.
You may want to set your keys up so we can get your windows up.
There's one on my
desk.
For those of you following along at home, here's what it says. That's the front. This is the back. That's funny. That's just funny. So, here's your blog question for the day. It is actually a medical condition if you have an erection that lasts for more than 4 hours. What's the word for that? And that's a Wikipedia page. You're really, really going to be sorry you bothered to read. That's up there with reading the Wikipedia entry on Rat King. Don't Google that.
Don't Google Rat King?
Rat King. You know what a Rat King is?
Only because of Adventure Time.
Okay.
They fought one.
They fought a Rat King?
Fought a Rat King. It was sentient, which I think regular Rat Kings are not, except in folklore.
Not so much. So this is a quadcopter kit.
I believe you.
Okay.
Because it
flies. You have to get it up?
It's kind of reaching.
Hey, I thought it was funny. What you doing? You got dinosaurs.
I do have dinosaurs. I can't find a good reconstruction of a Crixigonotosaurus, so...
He's got freaky little arms.
It does have freaky little arms. And if you watch our next episode, you can find out why. Sort of.
What are you doing? What are you doing?
Oh, we're creating a curtain. An iron curtain.
Okay. What's the backing material of this curtain going to be?
The green wall.
You're hanging these all from zip ties?
Yeah.
That's not going to work. Okay. You're going to hang these all from zip ties, and you're going to do it without drilling any new holes in my signs, right? How are you going to do that?
We're still working on that.
Okay. That's going to be fun. So, Harrison.
Yes?
I have in my hand a quadcopter kit for the Shrike quadcopter.
Oh, okay?
That's the front of the packaging. Mm-hmm. This is the back. I thought you'd appreciate that. Front. See, I like clever bits, like little Easter eggs in packaging. This is what we should be doing. We should strive for this level of clever. It's funny, it's a little cheeky, but it isn't actually dirty. It's clever. I like clever irreverence. That's how it should be done.
I should put that together.
Sausage dog! Hi.
What?
Do you need a cookie? Do you want a cookie? Well, I got the cat food, but you don't know. Here. You want a cookie? Watch this. I'll take a little pinch of cat food. Watch this. Friend for life. You want a cookie? Here. Have a cookie. Yay! Cookie! I figure you can't get that fat and be a picky eater. Yeah. Everything's a cookie. Everything's a cookie.
The cat?
The cat? He's probably outside. Sometimes he works the day shift. What the hell are you doing? What is this? Okay. It's for printing. There's a desk. There's... Ooh, what are you? This is interesting. What is this, sausage dog? It's a big old... It's an embossing setup. Repeat con skip. It's an addressograph. Okay. Looks 60s. Maybe earlier, could be 40s. Plastic type cleaner. Well, plastic didn't exist in the 40s, so. It's for a key company. Airways Leisureland. Okay. Huh, this is interesting. What?
I'm gonna leave it cracked open because as soon as it rains.
Giant storm and the cat, yeah.
He'll come running home.
Yep, alright. We have to protect the wee precious kitty. You say he's not an outdoor cat and he spends half his life outside. Well, what the hell do I know?
Ooh.
Hey guys, how about if we bring the grill in? How's that for an idea? The air outside is soup. Trees are inside out. Sky's turning fun colors. Captain to Batman. Come in, Batman. Bring the grill inside, please. Alright, I see a mowing crew. Where are you at?
you're out setting up to mow, that tells me you haven't seen a radar report in the past, huh?
Nice rig. Let's try and keep this guy from having a pretty bad day.
Looks like he's done. Because he's not here to do our lawn, and their lawn's freshly mowed, so... I'll be back. I'm gonna try and find this guy.
Doom approaches. Some interesting clouds over there.
Guessing I'm not gonna fly my sailplane today. It's just a hunch.
On the other side of the camera now.
Sometimes they do, and then they realize why I do this. And if, when you, no matter what you write, there's going to be comments, and you're going to have to edit them, especially for radio.
Check.
And idiot commenters will only get half the story, tend to have strong opinions about things they don't understand.
Ah, yes.
So
the commenter.
This gives you the ability to link to the long form of the whole interview that you can't put on your air, but I can put on mine. Cool. And just say, no, this is what we were actually talking about.
I can give a link. And for this, I was thinking, hoping early next week,
I'll put
airing
it on my
about,
Facebook so you'll be able to find it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Early next week, airing about, well, of course, I need to switch out the batteries.
What do you need?
No, I got more batteries in my thing. She was, I think the last thing I staffed was a city commission meeting.
Ooh,
so I had 3 hours of battery drain. Well, that's my choice.
Too much rig.
Just a couple. What's that?
Too much rig.
Well, she's not bad. She's old.
Yeah.
She eats batteries, but other than, I mean, it's functional.
So, do you run lithium or lipos in there?
I wish.
You can. At the very least,
I don't have a
iPad.
Are those rechargeable too?
Golden nickel metal halide, yeah.
I have been, it's a little bit of a front, looking front end investment, but not really that much.
Do you own it or is that station?
Station. Station.
I can send you a link to, I fly model airplanes a lot, and I get rechargeable AA batteries that, like, if you want to know the absolute leading edge of battery technology, hang out with model airplane guys because that's like our whole world. And I know where you get AA's. I just bought a set, and they're awesome. And I think they're nickel metal halide or something. I'm not 100%, but they're really, really badass AA's. And for what you do, it's perfect. Because you're pulling batteries down all the time.
Yeah, and she eats them.
Yeah.
I just didn't mean to leave like a...
Obviously, you're a horrible person with no respect for other people.
Right, with other, for other people's things.
Yeah, it's fine. I'm used to that.
The, yeah, my fiance and I bought just kind of a 60-pack cheap batteries.
Amazon?
Our first time at, no, it was at, it was our first time seeing Costco. We were like, 100 batteries! But I agree, rechargeable would be ideal and cheaper in the long run. Right?
In the long run, yes, but Costco batteries, stuff like that, the second brand batteries.
Yeah, I think they were like a sale on Duracell.
For what you're doing, are usually way better than spending money on like Duracell or Energizer.
Okay.
Because if you go by like watt hour versus dollar, you're going to save a lot of money by not going with like Duracell. There's times where you definitely want like a super duper name brand battery, but for this stuff, watt hour to the buck, buy the
I
cheap
think ones that came in were Amazon.
Yeah, buy the cheap Amazon batteries. We buy them like crazy.
We do recycle them.
Yeah.
What am I thinking? Oh, right. So early next week, I was going to air on. It was like, hey, they're working on a computer project, and that's really cool. And I think, like, earlier this morning, I saw something about, hey, if you need a cooling station, if it's too hot outside, feel free to duck in. So I just wanted to ask you some of the stuff you guys do around the community and why it's important. And then, ideally, a longer version of that interview would run in one of our news magazine programs.
Okay.
So it still might not be the entire thing.
I don't care.
But it'd be, like, 7-8 minutes.
You do whatever you want. I don't care how you edit me.
We can link to if you guys
nice.
Have stuff that...
Is the audio here okay for what you're doing, or do you want to quiet over?
Oh, that's a great question. It's not bad. I guess if you have something that's not quite so echoey...
If you need it quieter as well, not quite so echoey takes some doing, but if you need quieter space, I can make that. Because this is audio, so we can go anywhere in the building.
Oh. Let me...
I just want to get you good material.
It's so funny, because
I've done this for a while.
Yeah, and I'm so used to just like most of my stuff is just kind of stand up. So you interview where you happen to be located.
I understand. But if you want like studio quiet, I can do that.
Well, studio quiet shouldn't be a big deal. That's what it sounds like. Does all of this go up? Like,
oh, yeah.
Struggling with the headphones? All right.
Oh, like I've never done that.
Just hold them better. Let's see what we got. I'm debating. Yeah, I guess if there's someplace a little bit slightly quieter.
Oh, I know a great spot. I know a wonderful spot that is not echoey, small room, quiet location.
Arrow.
Yeah. I was thinking Studio A, but the reverb in there would be hell.
You mean they don't acoustically treat racquetball court?
We have a little bit.
Well, yeah, okay.
I cleaned it up.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
Okay.
Already been there.
All right. Hey, kids. Go on this way.
They like you.
Stay.
Hate.
Not really. Oh. Stay. Shit's so bad. Stay.
Pull up a chair, have a seat, anywhere you like.
Okay.
This room is a lot quieter. We get a little street noise here, but nothing major.
Oh, yeah, we can just. This will be.
Yeah.
Pass back and forth.
Drum, quad, quarter craft, whatever you want to call it. $2,000 that I can run into a smoking hole in the ground. Surprising, right, Kurt? It is not a hobby for the faint of heart.
I imagine that. Well, let's start pretty simple. Talk to me a bit about the Geek Group. What you guys do. What's available for people.
Okay. The Geek Group is a national science center, the largest nonprofit makerspace in the world, basically a giant collection of weirdos. That's our job. We're a place where people can come and explore science and technology and design and build anything they can imagine.
I don't even know how to...
Yeah, I get a lot of that.
Especially there's so much to do here.
And nobody knows we're here is the biggest problem. We've got all this stuff. We've got this huge resource for the community, and nobody knows we're here. We have no marketing budget.
Well, let's talk a little bit about community, because I feel like every couple months or so, I see something about the Geek Group or something that's going on or some way that you're working locally.
Mm-hmm.
What are some things that you do? Why is connecting to community important?
We do whatever we can because we can. That's the logic behind it. Like the cool-off shelter. This isn't a new thing for us. This is something we've done for years now. And it's, if there's a power outage, we put the word out to the community, hey, we have a place where you can come and charge your cell phone battery, and you know, if it's 300 degrees outside, we've got air conditioning, you can come here and cool off. If there's a super winter storm or something like that, you know, any major thing where people need a place to sleep, people need a place to get in out of the weather, it's not safe in your house. The building was built in the 50s, originally as a YMCA, so it's got that, it's a bunker, basically. We exist here in a giant cinder block bunker. And it's a lot sturdier than a lot of the standard, you know, factory houses, you know, the old school West Side houses in our neighborhood. And we have this space, we have this opportunity, we have this ability to help people. And it doesn't cost too much. It doesn't take a huge amount. I mean, yeah, we have to staff extra hours. It's like if we have people camped out here overnight in our lobby, then we have to have staff here 24/7. And those people need cots, and those people need water. Those, you know, they have fundamental physiological needs. And we can do this. We can keep these people safe. We can help our community. And every time I do it, somebody puts a camera in my face. Somebody puts a microphone in my face. I'm like, guys, this isn't the news. The real story here is, why isn't everybody else? It's not news that we're being decent people. That's not news. What's news is, why the hell doesn't everybody else do this? And why haven't they been doing this for 100 years? This is just common, fundamental, do unto others, be a basic, decent human being stuff. And Why wouldn't you do that? It's not news that we choose to do this. It's why wouldn't you do that? And it's a cultural thing.
But it's unique.
It shouldn't be. It shouldn't be unique. It shouldn't be special. This should be commonplace, everyday, boring stuff. It should be anything but news.
Well, talk to me about the computers, because that is a little...
That's kind of thing.
Boring. What's the program? What was the concept? What are you guys doing?
Okay, we get a lot of computers donated, and we always have. And we have, for decades, used a lot of computers in our space. We use them for projects. Members come here and do stuff. We go through a lot of machines. There's this really cool thing called Moore's Law. And technology gets better at an exponential rate. The density of transistors, stuff like that, about every 18 months. Back in 1994, when we started this place, the difference between your computer today and your computer last year was staggering. It was massive. Night and day difference. But it isn't anymore. And now, a computer that's 3 years old is perfectly fine if all you want to do is basic homework and get on the internet, check your email, write papers, look for a job, that stuff. It's not going to... It's going to suck for like a gaming console or something like that because the technology, you know, every 18 months. But for just basic web use, they're fine. So what we did is said, well, we've got a lot of space and we've got a whole army of interns that we need to teach about computers. So let's ramp up our computer throughput. Let's instead of getting computers just for us, let's really reach out and get a lot of computers. So we did. Thousands of them. And we have, because we have a volunteer staff, because we have all these guys that want to learn how to work on computers and want to fix computers. Well, what better way than, okay, kid, here's 100 computers, every single one needs to be totally taken apart, cleaned out, every single part in it tested, put it all back together again, you know, wipe the hard drive, put Linux on it, do the whole thing, ready to go, and do it right now. And by the way, we needed them 2 weeks ago. Go. They learn a lot in a hurry, and it's hands-on, and every computer has different problems. So they get to see, okay, well, this one's got a bad power supply, and they learn how to diagnose that, and they learn how to find bad memory, or a motherboard that's wonky, or a BIOS that needs problems. It's everything. And you'll put more computers in their hand in a single week than they'd get in a year in a classroom somewhere, or even in a tech job, because normal, like, you know, fix-a-job computer shops, they don't handle 1,000 computers in a week. They handle 1,000 computers in a year. So it's the educational side wins. The intern wins. The company donating the computers gets a huge tax write-off for them because they don't want to just pay somebody to haul them away. And most places charge. And they don't want to put them in a landfill because that costs money and screws the planet. So they can donate them here to a federally licensed nonprofit. And we just made GuideStar Platinum, which means we are the absolute ultimate pinnacle cream of the crop of accountability and transparency in the nonprofit world. GuideStar is who everybody is judged by. They're like consumer reports for nonprofits. And we just got platinum. There's over 2,200 nonprofits in the city of Grand Rapids. Care to guess how many are GuideStar platinum?
I don't think I can.
Three. Three. That's it. Exactly three. And we're the third. And the other ones are, one is a huge place you've probably heard of, and the other one is a little guy not far from here. Their entire annual operating budget is $2,000 a year, and their GuideStar Platinum. They only have $2,000, and they bother to fill out mountains of paperwork because they believe in accountability and transparency. I think that's really awesome.
Who's the second guy?
That's the guy who's only got like $2,000. The third is us. And because of that, the company's donating it because we're GuideStar Platinum, because we're federally certified as a 501c3, all that jazz. They get a nice tax write-off for it, and they know religion. They know that when we say, we're going to do this, we're going to do that, and they can track it in the blog, and they can see it on our live stream, they can see
it. They can watch it in a...
They can watch it. This is the blog. With that camera, every day, the video goes out to the internet. And it doesn't go out on official Geek Group channels, it's my private personal thing, but it's just, this is what I did today. And it's part of that whole accountability and transparency thing. So the company wins. The intern wins, the company wins. And we put those together, we leverage it with our resources, and we say, okay, we can sell this computer in a typical desktop. In the last batch we just did, cost us $47. Between gas in the truck to go get it, people to move it around, you know, all the stuff, all the parts cost everything, $47. On average, per unit cost. So we put a $50 price tag on it because math is easy, and that covers the taxes on selling it. and off you go. $50. And it's great. It's, this puts a decent, it's not like, oh my god, computer, but it's a computer that doesn't suck.
Yeah.
That's the line. It's a computer that doesn't suck. Does your computer suck? Yes. Okay, this one doesn't. Here. And we put Linux on all of them, so the software is free. And it's like free as in the people and free as in beer. It's all open source. And there's huge resources available there for, like, if you want educational stuff for your kid, if you want stuff for getting a job, it's all out there. And it's free, and it's easy to find. And we get a lot of people that are terrified. It's like, oh, Linux, what's that? It's like, do you have a smartphone? Yes. You know Linux. Shut up. Here, go.
Oh, that's true, that's true.
Yeah, if you have an Android phone, it's running Linux.
Yeah.
There you go. And the people win. Because now, for $50, you can get a computer. And if you have four kids at home, it's $200. Get each kid a computer. They don't have to fight over it. And they're Linux, so they're not going to get viruses. They're not going to screw it up. For $200, you can get individual computers for a family of four. For $200, you'd be hard-pressed to buy a new computer, at like especially one that doesn't suck, at like Best Buy or OfficeMax or something like that. You walk in the door there, and even a cheap basic computer is, you know, over $200, like $300-$400 for just a basic office setup. And why? And if you need that, like, if you can afford that, cool, do that. I don't want to sell computers to people who can afford nice new $400 computers. I want to sell computers to people who are, in their soul, deeply thankful that this exists and they can get a computer. Because they don't care. They don't care that it's 3 years old. They don't care that they can't do serious gaming on it. They don't care. It works. And it fills their need. And this is a tiny little way that those of us in the computer nerd world can have a tangible, like a real, visceral, tangible, positive impact on people's lives. Because to work in the computer world as like a computer tech and stuff like that, 90% of the time they don't even think about you, and the 1% they do is when everything's gone to hell and you're getting screamed at. People
yeah.
that work in the computer world, nobody thinks about it. It's a thankless job. This is an opportunity where I've got guys over here that are getting hugs from crying moms on a daily basis because they're so thankful that they were able to do this. And that's awesome. That's the best paycheck.
One of the reasons I got in touch, one thing I really liked was this connection to technology and how important it is today. But for, you know, various financial reasons, income reasons, you're right, the family can't go and buy four brand new expensive
laptops. And it's true with everything in this building. It's like, everything we do is about access. Like, really, if you boil it all down, just like all science boils down to physics. Which boils down to math. No matter which branch of science you're in, it all ends up at math. Everything we do here ends up at access. Access to technology, access to tools, access to equipment, access to facilities, access. And I believe that people as a whole, individuals, not groups, individuals, you take one, you just grab a dude off the street. People are good and they're smart. You just have to give them an honest shot. And they'll surprise you. 9 times out of 10, they'll surprise you. In groups, they get dumb. The bigger the group, the dumber they get. But individuals are good, and they're smart. So if you want to come here, and you want to use power tools, or lasers, or a vehicle hoist, or, you know, all 10,000 different things that will kill you the moment you don't respect it, I'll put the faith in you that you're not a Muppet. That you understand that stupid hurts, and that you're accountable for your own actions, that actions have consequences. These are things that nobody talks about anymore. This is grandpa stuff. Actions have consequences. Clean up your mess when you're done. That stuff. That's my whole world. That's my job. And what I do is say, okay, you can change your own life. You can do this. You don't have to go and pay somebody to change your own life. You can do this. But doing it in your driveway sucks. It's 2 hours on your back in the dirt, and there's schmutz everywhere, and it just sucks. But if you just had a hoist, if all you had was just a hoist, now it's a 20-minute job, and it's way cleaner, and it's way easier, and it's way safer. But you don't have $5,000 for a hoist. You don't have the three-phase power to power it. You don't have the space in your garage to fit it. You don't have a hoist. But I do. And for a couple bucks an hour, like $5 an hour, you can come here and use my hoist. And now I get to share my toy with you. I get to provide access. And you get to do a thing you couldn't do before, and you get to do it safely, and you get to do it supervised so that we make sure you don't drop the car on your head. And you get to be a little chuffed because I changed my oil. It's
awesome. Cool.
And that empowers people. That chuff, that I did that, I made that, I fixed that. And you get to learn stuff. Because right now, I'd be willing to bet $20 right now that you don't know why people use magnetic oil drain plugs. You probably didn't even know that existed 30 seconds ago.
No.
Turns out it's a thing you want to buy. It costs like $5. There's nothing to it. But you don't know why. But you could know, because you're not stupid. You just need the opportunity to learn that. You need somebody to give you access to a hoist to say, okay, I'm going to let you, because if you walk into your car dealership and say, hey, you got a hoist, can I use that? They're going to laugh at you. No, because you can't do that. You're a girl. Girls can't wrench. Oh, my God. No, that's bullshit. So come here. You can. We have the insurance. We have the tools. We have everything you need for you to be able to use any tool you can imagine. And we have more tools in this building right now that you can use than Home Depot has for sale. There's a lot. There's a lot to it. And we have all these toys, and I want to share them with you.
Not to, well, just to go back to the computers as far as numbers. So when I saw the post, it was, hey, we have these computers. We've got a couple hundred computers. Mm-hmm. $50, or you can do 40, you know, whatever.
Yeah, if you want just the box, it's $40.
How many... What's the, is this something that's going to go on in perpetuity? Is there a
yes.
hard number?
My goal is 6,000 this year.
Okay.
That's what I'm pushing towards, is 6,000 machines this year. And I have to bring a lot of things together to do that. But it's going very well. It's going much better than we dreamed. And the side effects to it are what gets really cool. Because there's the whole initial thing of, hey, let's help people out, let's get them computers. And then I saw weird things happen. Weird cultural mojo happened. I saw people on the Facebook post, and you can read it, they're in there, in the original Facebook post, in Verify Science. People commented saying, I wish I could do this, but I've only got like $30. And other people would jump in and say, well, I'll spot you this one. You know, if this woman needs two computers for her family, I'm in. Just $100, I'm in. And they would arrange it on their own. Because they started out wanting to give me money, saying, here, just... I was like, no. I don't have the infrastructure for that. I don't want to be responsible for tracking it. This is a feasibility study. We're not there yet. We're just seeing if this works. So they started meeting on their own here. They arrange it. They do all the homework. These are people that have never met each other before. They don't know each other. They come from different sides of the tracks. Because you've got one woman who doesn't have enough money for groceries this week, much less a computer. And another guy who's like, well, I got an extra $100. Sure, why the hell not? And they meet here. And there's tears, and there's hugs, and there's, oh my God. And it's the greatest thing ever, man. It's these, all the bullshit lines, all the cultural lines of white people, black people, straight people, gay people, fat people, skinny people, all the bullshit lines that we insulate ourselves with that don't matter. For a tiny moment, I got to see all the bullshit get put aside because they're people. And once you get people to realize that they're people, then it all changes, and it's awesome to watch. So yeah, that's really cool. I like it. I like it a lot.
I think that was part of why that stuck out to me, because you started with this post, and then I just started seeing people, and I admit it's kind of after the fact, so maybe it's like it might be too late to have. So I gotta contact them for the next time that they're doing something cool, because I feel like I'm always seeing this stuff after the fact. But yeah, it was exactly that. It was someone saying, oh, you know, I have 30, and someone else saying, oh, I have extra money, or how can I donate? How can I buy a computer for the next family that wants it? And I just thought that was really cool. How many, or do you have numbers on how many you sold?
So far, it's about 400, I think. 400? I'm not entirely sure. We don't really keep track. It's just how fast can we get them in, how fast can we get them out.
Sure.
It's in the hundreds.
And for people who might be interested in helping out, whether that's donating old computers or financial resources, is that something that...
We're establishing the infrastructure for it right now, but a big thing that I want to do is, because there's a lot of people that want to donate, there's a lot of people that are like, I'm going to kick in $50, I want to buy a computer for a family. But the infrastructure to do that is considerable, because some people want to donate $50 anonymously. Some people want it where, you know, their name's on it. And I want to make it where if they want their name on it, I give somebody a computer and it has the donor's name on it and their email address and say, here's the person you want to call and thank because they just bought you a computer. And most people just want to do it anonymously. But for the people that don't, I'm like, yeah, here, go get your attaboy. That's cool. Do it. You know, I mean, you bought somebody a computer. So, yeah, you deserve an email and a thank you, and why the hell not? And we're coding the website stuff for that right now. And it'll go public on my Facebook, and put a link in here to my Facebook. People can find it easy. But I'll do a post, and we're big thing is that it's not limited just to the Northwest side. When we did the feasibility study, we limited, like, for the first day to this is just for West Siders, just the Upper West Side. And now it's, if you can walk in our door, cool. We're not shipping them. I get people in Alaska and Oklahoma, Texas, have all contacted me saying, you know, can, I was like, that's great, I can't, I don't, it costs more money to ship than the damn thing's worth. It's, yeah. It's just, yeah. It's not, I can't do
how
it.
How would they hear cool. That?
There's, just burn off? That internet thing.
Yeah.
It's
yeah.
On computers now. It's on phones. All the cool kids have it.
Yeah. They get one of those
but it's, it, I can help you with this, but it's, when we do it this time, I'm going to be looking for people specifically that do want to donate, because that helps us do it faster, because I can get ahead of the curve. Because we can only cover the expenses in the program as we sell computers to raise money for the program, so that's my, it's a self-limiting problem. And I need to get ahead of the curve, and if I have people that can say, yeah, I'll kick in $50. And I'm sure that there are companies around here that would say, yeah, we'll buy 10. Just put us down for 10, here's our credit card. And I want to make it stupid simple on my website they can go to. And we've already got a lot of infrastructure for processing donations because we're a nonprofit. But I want to do one specifically, like separate from our main donations page. And I want a thing where you can go to it and it's stupid, simple, and easy to use. And you can use credit card or PayPal or whatever the hell you want. If you want to walk in the door with $50, cool, whatever you want. And that's, yeah.
Can you use donations of computers or just that?
God, yes. I need all the computers. Like, if Grand Valley has this year's batch of computers, because a lot of them get sent off to scrapyards or CompuRenew, stuff like that, we want them. I don't want you to pay me money to take your computers. I don't want to charge people for their old machines. It's absolutely a donation. Put them on a truck, bring them on over. If you got a lot of them, put them on pallets. If you can't ship them, and if you have like ones or twos, we really don't want to go pick them up because it takes a lot of time and it's so much money in gas in the van. But if you have like 100 computers in your company sitting somewhere, then give us a call. If it's anywhere in the Southwest Michigan area, we'll come pick them up. I mean, we're picking up a batch out of Kazoo, it's 200 machines. We're getting them from Rockford, from Kalamazoo, from Muskegon, Grand Haven, Holland, all over the place. If you have a pile of computers, I want it. I don't care if they work, I don't care how old they are, I don't care. The only thing we won't take is CRT monitors. The big, remember the big boxy cube monitors? We can't take them. Because I can't use them and I can't get rid of them. They cost a fortune to recycle. Yeah. So anything else, though, we want. If you've got 5-year-old flat panel, like these ugly little things back here, the little, like the 15-inch, you know, ones, those are like 6 years old. We'll take them. There's nothing wrong with them. We'll use them. I got people that need them.
Chris, anything?
Just need to move.
Do you guys need to?
I'm not Moose or Jesse. It's okay.
usually I ask, is there anything else you want to add? Da, da, da.
There
I
is one thing I want to add.
In this case, there's a ton, but yeah.
There's
yeah.
One really, like, it's my job, it's my mission in life to leave a lasting, positive impact on the lives of every person I meet. I need to teach you something really important. Do you know the difference between cardioid and omnidirectional?
Oh boy, I should.
You really should.
Especially
I'm
going to
teach you. Okay.
Cardioid is directional, right? And to try to and then
like a heart.
Yeah.
Because cardioid, it's actually an upside down heart.
I will keep that one.
Okay.
Cardioid.
See,
okay.
Now you remember cardio.
Yeah.
Cardioid. Yeah. It's shaped like a heart. Okay. The polar pattern of this microphone is shaped like a heart. That it doesn't pick up very well from the back.
Sure.
Okay. But it picks up very well out front. Not so much from the sides, but very well out front. And usually they're labeled, but this is a beep up. It's probably, it looks like an old
electric voice. It's a public radio microphone.
It is. It's a public radio microphone. Looks like an old electric voice from the style. But this microphone is probably a cardioid or a hypercardioid microphone. Cardioid is like this.
Right.
And a hypercardioid just stretches, it's a long, skinny heart. Okay, so it picks up really well out here and nothing from this height. So when you're using a microphone, you can't fucking talk with your hands. You can't
do this
because it makes me crazy. I've got way too much value. You're gonna cut out everything I said.
No,
you're gonna feel bad, and I want everybody on the internet to write her and tell
her. If I meet on WGBNews.org, and find my byline.
Tell me your name.
Hillary Farrell. H-I-L-A-R.
Think about that.
Hillary
spell
Farrell.
Your name.
H-I-L-A-R-Y. F as in Frank. A-R-R-E-L-L. My email.
Don't do that.
Okay.
You know why?
But you can find me.
Geek group. The wide open internet.
Fair enough.
The neckbeards. You're going to get emails of like, you look pretty.
I usually, if I'm doing,
you talk with your hands, I do the same thing.
To go real geek, it's, technically it's able to record two channels simultaneously. So, in
so
ideal
setup. Desk stand.
Correct. And then
you'd
like
be
nice
and
I'd
well, you get a little desk stand. They cost nothing. Go to Musician's Friend. Buy one of your own.
Yeah,
they're like $20. You little desk stand with the iron base. Don't get the tripod crap. Get one with proper iron base.
I have one.
Get a little thing about this high, because the desk stands are like 6 inches high.
Yeah.
And then on top, you get a set, what's called an XY set of mic clips. You put two mics on it. You point one here, you point one there.
Oh.
And you never touch it. Because that way you don't get handling noise.
Yeah.
And because it's a shitty old public radio mic. So, look at that! Look at that! It's loose as a Catholic womb!
It works for what I need it to.
For now?
It's a fine
for this moment? That microphone's probably...
But yeah, when I finish it, I edit out all the mic sound and put them back and forth.
You're right, start with about a 60 hertz. I'd go up to about 70 hertz with a high-pass filter. Just cut out everything under 75 hertz because the lowest fundamental of the male human voice is at about 75 hertz, give or take. So if you cut out everything under that, you get rid of a lot of wind noise and handling noise and just all that crap. And when you run this through post, just high pass filter. Okay, so it'll look like that.
Yeah.
Everything up here goes, everything down here we start rolling off. And just roll it off nice and smooth. So it's my time to teach you this stuff. I don't know shit about being a journalist. But if it comes to recording audio, man, I know stuff.
Got some corrections.
Besides, we got time because you don't want to go out now.
No, I don't. Last time I almost lucked out when we finished the tour. It wasn't raining anymore, so anything's possible. I don't usually. Maybe it's an audition thing.
What?
A lot of the filters, I'll strip on a certain decibel, and it works nicely for you need cord noise, but you're plugged into a malt box.
Well, going by decibel controls the rate of your filter, how sharp that roll-off is. Like, if you have all the high all the low frequencies and the high frequencies, and you want to cut this off with, like, a low-pass filter?
Oh, the
decibel stuff is usually, like,
by frequency.
You cut it off by frequency, but the decibel rating is how tight that slope is. Because you can have a nice mellow roll-off, or you can have, like, a fucking cliff, and it's all, you can do a lot with it.
I have
the software. Just play with it.
This is my...
You got a dead cat!
Look
at that.
Yeah.
That's quality.
But it's not great for interviews when it's so close.
I
want to
see what's under your neckers here. What do you got?
It's
an NTG2.
Yeah.
It's a nice mic.
Yeah.
This is way better.
When you're too close, it's just going to peak the whole time.
Well, that's because this is what's called a shotgun.
Right.
This is really, really sensitive like this.
Yep, and then...
And it's terrible to the sides. And this is if you have to use this in an interview, hold it way down like that.
I hold up.
Yeah, you can. For in this room, had I thought ahead better and when we were shooting here, you see the little metal clips in the ceiling, the little metal hoopy things.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, we could have taken this and just hung it right about for what we're doing in here. I'd actually hung it by the cable and I'd put the mic about here, and it would have had a nice even mix for
but
both of us.
Catching?
It's not going to get much. What it's really going to get, if it's a cardioid mic or a hypercardioid mic, it's pointed at the table. So as we talk, when we're just facing each other, there's a lot of reflected sound off here. So this is going to get that, and it's going to be very bright, and it's going to have a very high presence. You'll notice a proximity and a presence effect in microphones, where, and experiment, try this at home, but hold the mic out here and talk, and you'll notice that when you get up to about here, it just roar, like it gets really big testicles, and that's your presence, your proximity effect on the mic. And it's why, for a lot of mics, they're designed to be used. Like a Shure SM58, which is the most common handheld vocal mic on Earth, is a standard SM58. It looks like an ice cream cone. It's
like
a ball.
Yeah,
it's a Shure SM58. And it's what this old shitty EV really wishes it could be. And the SM58 is designed to be, you know, right here.
Yep.
Just go, dude, that's your mic. That's where you want your mic. Don't eat it.
Right.
Keep it right there, and you can beat.
So that's the other one with the control, because if I pass it back, and if I had
yes,
known that you were such an expert.
I'm not an expert, I've made all these mistakes.
Because people will reach for the microphone,
oh, yeah.
But then they'll...
Never give up your mic.
It'll just get real, 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 real close, and so
yep.
I have to cut out all the
because,
keys and the consonants.
Yep.
And
it's most of the people you deal with don't have a lot of mic experience. Anybody who's experienced in this is not going to grab the mic, and they're not going to try and eat the mic. In doing this kind of stuff a lot, certain things I've learned is have a good grip. Okay. Keep it far enough away, because if you get it close, they're going to grab it. If you put something in their face, they're going to grab it.
Sure.
And if you're ever, because of what you do, you'll come across this. If you're ever in a situation where you're on stage or something like that, and you need a volunteer, and you have anybody in the audience, just go, me!
Yeah.
Don't ever
pick that one.
Oh my God. If you see somebody who gets very interested in their belt all of a sudden, don't pick them either. Because you're like, okay, I need to go.
Don't pick
them, because it's going to suck.
Yeah.
But the people who are that eager, don't do it. And because once they get hold of your microphone, just set the room on fire. You're done. Just never give up your mic.
Moderations. I think this is, I'm going to do a sign off just in case. I'm going to try to use a larger segment of it. So not just using like a 50, I mean...
This is GDU GBK...
Yeah, GDU
8.5?
Mm-hmm. Yep, 95 frames speaking. Do you want to... I was just going to... You know, Chris, thank you for... All right, give me a bumper.
You're listening to WGDU GBK 88.5 and some other fucking number on the speaker.
Yeah, that's usable.
What's the other one?
95
Yeah.
You're
listening to WGDU GBK... God, I'm writing it down because I'm a retard.
This is all usable.
It's 88.5. What is it?
Like half
what
of just
it?
A curse.
88.5, 95.3. 95.3. I never listened to that.
95.3 is, well, you wouldn't. It's
95.3 is missing.
Yeah.
You've been listening to WGDU, WGDK, 88.5 FM, and 95.3 out of ski.
That's good. There's our legal ID.
Yeah.
Most of it, at least. Is that right?
Yeah, that's most of the legal ID.
Yeah.
You need 88.5 Grand Rapids, 95.3 to ski in Michigan.
Do we need to say where it's licensed? Is it Allendale?
Not really, Eugene. Now, when do you have to do the legal ID?
Well, coming into
top and bottom.
And bottom, too.
What's your buffer?
Mm-hmm.
Where at top of the hour? Does it have to be right on, or do you have some wiggle?
It's within a minute, isn't it?
2 minutes.
2 minutes.
Yep. You have a 5-minute window centered at the top of the hour, so you have 2.5 before, 2.5 behind. That's what the law used to be like a million years ago. I don't know anymore, but that's what we used to have to do.
That's more or less. Usually, if I'm anchoring, I'm hitting it. 59, 30,
okay.
459, kind of
yeah.
Depending on traffic and all of that. Chris, what is your last name?
Boden. Bravo, Oscar, Delta, Echo, November.
And what is your, ask at the beginning, title? Founder, co-founder, tinkerer?
Can I go with
organizer?
Like, big asshole in charge?
You can, but I gotta bleep that.
Yeah. You can swear on PBS!
You can't swear. What
you
do
want
you
that?
I swear we're on NPR, not PBS.
Okay. I have seen.
You can't swear.
I have seen with
well,
my own eyes.
Okay.
They broadcast fuck on out of the TV station WGDU. They broadcast the
was
word fuck, and I saw it. It was part of a movie. And this is back in 1998.
Okay.
I was watching PBS, and they had this whole movie. They were talking about some interview thing, and they were talking about a movie, and it was. Some actor was really big in the 90s. It was like the not-quite-Seinfeld guy. And he's in this scene, and they're doing this 50s thing. They're in a diner, and it's all these biker dudes, like, you know, like the Jets.
kind of thing.
Okay.
And it's just two dudes talking. He's like, so I went out with this girl last night, and I drove her out to the thing in the middle of nowhere. He's like, yeah, what happened? He's like, I threw her in the back seat and said, fuck her fight. And I'm like, no! So I was very happy. I wanted to actually file a compliment. No, 98.
I want to file a compliment with the FTC.
Well, everybody files a complaint with the FTC. I want to file a compliment. I was like, yes! Do that! This is good!
Okay.
But I figured that probably would be better for me. I think is somebody actually broadcast it and wasn't actually paying attention to what was going on because I've been there.
Yeah.
And when I did it, I got suspended for 30 days. So.
That is, you see, those words are...
Turns out people actually talk like that.
Well, sure.
So.
Decency, you know, rules and FC.
Okay. We have Trump about to get elected president.
I can't talk about this.
Telling you about decency, please.
Yeah.
Okay.
let's do a sign up.
Chris Boden. President, founder of the Geek Group National Science Center.
Sit up there.
Defender of the realm, leader of the West.
I'm sorry, you know that, Jaden. Chris Boden, president and founder of the Geek Group. Thanks for talking to us.
I'm happy to help. Thank you for having me. You guys are awesome.
Yeah, we'll see about that.
I want defender of the crown in there, damn it!
That was good. Thank you.
It's my job to make your job as easy as I can.
Yeah, all of that extra. I'm just like, oh yeah, here's some stuff for your prep.
You were not expecting that, were you?
Well, I don't.
It's like, hey, here's all of your notes that you need for tomorrow.
I try very hard not to reach out on Facebook.
It's so much easier.
It is a lot easier.
If you do it on Facebook chat, I have 18 screens in front of me.
Oh, yeah,
and
really?
Okay, you want this and this and this and this, because I can't expect you to know everything instantly.
Some of it is just kind of having a more official vibe. Some of it is some people have, you know, legitimate privacy concerns, or they just don't want to be, you know, hey, I'm a news reporter up in your Facebook messages, but you had tagged us in the, I think it was the Guide Star, and when I saw it, I was like, oh, right now, I'm gonna message him right now because I was meaning to get in touch on the computers.
I gave
and
up
just really cool.
Any concept of privacy a long time ago. It's my job to be the opposite of that. It's my job to be a spectacle. It's my job to say, hey, look here, we're doing cool stuff! Donate, you fuckers! And if I could do that, if I could stand on top of the Yomi Grand with a Stratocaster and say, we're teaching kids about science, we're helping families with computers, we're keeping old people from dying of heat stroke, fucking help us, we're broke.
People come when you do?
It varies
wildly.
Sometimes, like, we'll get a power outage and we might get two people, and then sometimes we'll have a power outage and we have 50 people, and I need cots.
Is this kind of is this like more of a long-standing thing?
It really boils down to just be decent. Be decent to people. We're not pushing Jesus on people, we're not doing any of that happy worship, it's just, be decent to people! Maybe I can get people to start noticing.
Do you,
My ultimate goal is to fuck it for everybody.
Is to what?
Fuck it for everybody. Just like, okay, every Saturday afternoon we give a tour, the same tour you just got,
okay.
Right?
Yeah.
After the tour, I personally sit down with the tour group and avail myself to any question they want to ask. There are no rules. And I do this on the YouTube camera and we have live broadcasts. We have three
TV
cameras. Maybe, I don't know. Maybe, I never know. But I do this as publicly as possible with no filter, we don't run a tape delay or anything. It's out there right now. And I do this because if I can get the average person on the street to realize that if I can do it, and I have no budget, I'm no budget, I'm just a little dude in the science center. If I can do it as the president of the company, if I can make the time every week, if I can answer any question they ask, I do it on camera and on YouTube.
Oh, yeah, you guys have a simulcast.
Yeah.
Yeah.
If I do this, I can get people to learn that they can ask questions and demand evidence of people in power. And that is what I mean when I say I want to fuck it for everybody. Because why can't we do it? If I can do it, why can't the president of the Red Cross? Why can't the president of PETA? Why can't the president of the Komen Foundation? Why can't people walk into their office every Saturday afternoon and say, where's the money go? I donate $20, where's it go? How do pink dumpsters cure cancer? Teach me this stuff. I want to know. So I do that. I want to set the example because I want to ruin it for everybody else. Because if I can get people to ask questions and demand evidence,
yeah, that'd be the norm.
That makes the world a better place. Critical fucking thinking, man. It works. It really does. Yeah, there's a lot.
because it's it.
I got enough stuff here to give you a story every week, and I'm your puppy. Like,
you're my puppy.
I am your bitch, absolutely. Anytime you need anything science, technology related, you're doing a story on an oil spill or kids doing rockets or anything, I want to be your science bitch.
Okay. We, how do you usually, I mean, do you have any sort of like email list that you send out to people? Or
no, I just use my Facebook.
Okay.
I'm not a guy who posts like 20 things a day on Facebook. I don't post stupid cat pictures and shit like that. 90% of the stuff on my Facebook is original content, and there's always something. And if I'm doing something in particular, you'll see it.
Okay.
If it's on my Facebook, you'll know.
What is
you got a card?
Yeah.
Cool. Give me your card.
What's the when you were talking about the website? When should people their eyes out for that or more information?
For the new thing?
If they were gonna, you know.
As soon as the damn thing's done. And it's probably going to be within the next couple days. And I'm going to give you one of my super secret personal cards that has all my info on.
All your info.
All my info. That's got like my super secret cell phone and all that info.
That is not. I can probably remember a couple days. This isn't one of. And I can just point people to the geek group.
To the geek group's Facebook page for like up to the minute info. It'll be on the Facebook page.
Okay.
When we start selling computers again, I'll put it on there. It'll hit my personal Facebook first. And then it'll go up to the geek groups like 2 minutes later.
Okay, cool.
We are really big here at being very nimble and very real time. Mm-hmm. We don't work at the glacial pace of business. And I take a lot of pride in that fact. Like, if you call me up and be like, I'm doing a story, I need to talk about super tankers. I don't know shit about super tankers, but I will. You know, you give me 2 hours and I can talk competently on just about anything.
All right. Okay.
You give me 24 hours and I can be an expert on it. At least enough for a 30-second soundbite.
Yes. I invite you over to give us all microphone training.
I would be happy to come out and give you all microphone training.
That'd
be fun as hell.
You want my what?
I want your chunk. I want you to get the word out to people around Grand Valley.
So we usually have a
strongly recommend everybody reviews the captain's blog on the proper use of the radio. Everyone. We have exactly 2 people that do it well. Oh, it's a light one today. Cool. I only have 3 things I have to yell at people about. This is fun. Oh, hang on. Before I go, any word on Mike?
No. Not for lack of trying. Just
keep getting voicemail?
Yeah.
Alright. The office. That room over there, that's the office. This is the lobby, that's the office. The office is a place of work, and we cannot do that if it's being treated as a place to hang out. If you want to hang out for a few minutes, we have a lobby. That's this room, nearby. But far enough away so as not to be disruptive to the people in the office. The people in there tend to be doing important shit. The people who come in to hang out up there tend not to be doing important shit. Probably have important shit to be doing. If you are signing up a member, do it in the lobby. That's this room. That's the office. Where there are sign-up computers, over there. Be aware of your surroundings. If you are giving a tour and stop in the office to continue with a lot of conversation, move it somewhere else. This also applies if you are elsewhere in the building where people are trying to concentrate. Do not take chairs from the office. Who the hell takes chairs from the office?
I would love to know.
Okay. If you need chairs, Studio A is Ted's deep in them. Take as many as you like. Feel free to leave them in other buildings. Late shift. It is fine if you need to have somebody cover a portion of your late shift. Be aware of who you are asking and do not consistently ask the same person for help. If you feel that... you could say it like that. If you feel that... Can I help you?
They're helping themselves. Thank you very much.
Give me the rope.
You take it away from their whipping heads.
Hi. Oh, fuck off. fucked my entire day. Anything as it requires somebody else to bring you to a different night. You must now fill out a form when you have somebody to cover your shift. It's a simple, easy form, display form.
You all have the form.
Remember, if somebody covers your shift in any capacity, you need to reciprocate. This is true of a lot of things in life.
I'm
going to
leave that one all alone.
Move on.
You can't write this shit and not expect me to run with it. I'm sorry, but there's just...
Reciprocate, that's how we got to sell your truck.
That's how we got...
I have no regrets.
Did what he had to do.
And towed, by the way.
Please place the shift agreement...
I wrote it, sorry.
She can't type
it. I can't type.
Like, you typed this on a computer, right? They put little squiggly red lines on your shit?
I didn't look back. I just moved on.
No regrets.
Yep, no regrets. No regrets.
Please place the stiff agreement form once it is signed by all parties on Melissa's desk. You really have to work on
here.
Your grasp of English and your casual relationship with grammar. Because I don't mind standing up here having to read this stuff, but I should not sound like I have an IQ of room temperature when I'm doing it. I'm dumb enough all on my own. Responsibilities. That's what happens when you don't reciprocate. You end up having responsibilities. We understand that you are all very busy, but follow-through is becoming a major issue lately. If you start a task, fucking finish it. Not finishing tasks is how we end up with garbage cans without bags in them, donation receipts half completed, donations half put away, and dogs locked in the bathroom.
She's very unhappy.
I'm okay with that. If you are in the middle of a task when somebody asks for you on the radio, state what you are working on. Don't be a dick when you do it. Be nice on the radio. The whole building is listening when you do that, for the love of fuck. State what you are working on, inquire if it can wait, if it cannot, or how long it will take, make a... See, you can't write it like that.
I didn't write that one.
Make it a point to complete your task as soon as possible. We have had an influx of small donations lately. Yay. We have also had an influx of donation receipts not having any content in them and left sitting on top of the pile of donated goods. These must be completed when the donation is received. You actually have to fill it out, preferably with the person standing there. It's okay if they're going to, you know, make your day a bit of a pain in the butt. You can make it their day. Dogs in there like, ah, come
on! Don't get your boss.
Runs free!
Hi. Running the balls.
She left her rope in there.
That's right, they can't play with it.
I don't have your rope. You're an idiot. Also, now we have to enter the second page of notes I have, which consists entirely of Happy Birthday, Elizabeth.
Yay!
There is cheesecake. There is love and sunshine.
And running.
Running. Fuck my entire life.
Echoes.
Did you get cheesecake? I'm guessing no. Hi. How you doing? I don't have your rope.
Mac, where's the rope?
Where's the rope? Where's Echo?
Right here, lady.
See, you're the good dog. She's just like,
yeah.
through this, you may not be familiar with this, but are you aware of the loaves and fishes problem? You have two small cheesecakes and the multitudes.
Let me introduce you to the multitude. And you're welcome.
Usually cheesecakes are meant for small, you know.
Yes.
Yes, they are. But then there's guys like you who just walk up with a little straw and just go. Is that a pumpkin cheesecake?
Caramel.
Oh, this is a thing that exists in my life.
Oh, wow.
Thank you. They're bringing out straws.
And New York.
I've already felt my arteries blood.
Oh, hang on.
It's all on the show, too.
As they're off.
Who wasn't the same running the bowls?
We should totally make one of those little follower robots have like robotics and just trace the dogs down the track.
No.
Because they usually do it with rats.
No, because then Elisa goes floop and jumps on it.
Yeah. 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 So we do a super speed line follower, perfect line. Watch them go all day.
That's behavior.
So, well, Mac can probably manage to figure out by the end of the day. Elisa's coming.
It's her ears that kill me.
Oh, you know,
they flap. Yeah.
Ain't nothing on that table for you to be interested in.
Tennis ball.
Any questions? Concerns? Comments from the rabble?
Rabble.
How are we doing on computers, Paul?
Imaging.
Oh, speaking. How many are done? Computer lab.
About 40.
About 40 today. About 40 today.
Yeah.
On top of what was done yesterday.
Yeah.
How is the total in robotics?
I haven't been in robotics.
I haven't been down there.
How is? Do you
so
have
three.
The file down in the computer lab?
Yeah, we're doing end of the time.
Okay. So. How about after we take everybody and we move a pile? Because we have a herd of people today. I'll have everybody just, we'll do a big circuit.
We
we'll
didn't get plates, did we?
We're out of plates.
All right. Sure.
It works.
We have more in it?
No.
Nope. We didn't even have plates last night. You were eating off paper towels?
Yes, you did. You were doing that the week before, but then I miraculously found plates sitting in the carpet next to it.
I forgot to go to Walgreens before.
Are you mathing?
No.
Okay.
There's
no math?
There's no math involved here. I'm just cutting them and we can do it like thunder.
By the way, how many of you have voted on the mercantile bank thing?
Is it an IP address
based? You know what?
It's
Facebook based.
Oh,
Facebook based.
All right. How many of you have not voted on the mercantile bank thing? Okay.
Vote
on the damn mercantile bank thing. If you can't find it, it's on the Geek Group Facebook, my Facebook, it's all over Facebook.
My Facebook.
My Facebook.
Incidentally, you could also go to the mercantile bank Facebook page.
Oh,
okay. Vote, share.
It isn't in the topic for IRC.
Because right now, we're actually in the lead.
We are.
Yeah,
we're
right.
I think we're going to be by the 50 last.
Chris.
Yes. Hi.
Do you know... Are you aware of a vectorscope in this building?
Metroscope?
Vectorscope?
He claims there was like a nice one in the van, but
I
don't
believe it. We get them on a regular basis.
I can also offer you a spoon.
Alright. grab one of the Hamlet ones and do it with that.
Where are they?
Thank you.
Fuck, I don't know
what
they're around. It's a 1U thing. It says Hamlet and other stuff, but it's a vectorscope, but it isn't the whole, it's just the brain of a vectorscope. It works with any monitor. And then you can do
it on big
LCD monitors. It's one of these upstairs in the CCC. I've got an old shitty one I've had up there forever, and it works great. There were two in surplus that I took out of surplus and went back into your work, so find those. But I know that there are at least two of the Hamlets around here, plus God knows how many of the shitty old single-strain little vectorscope things.
Well, that's a wee piece. Thank you. So do I have any questions from anybody on the shift stuff? No questions means I assume that you will use it.
I would like to do that. I'd like to do a video on the graphic. That'd be really cool.
Echo! What are you doing? You're You're not supposed to be outside. Come on. Echo, come here. Come here. What are you doing? What are you doing outside? You're not supposed to be out here. Yeah. Come on. Come on. Let's go. Let's go inside. Let's be a good dog. Man, if Batman found out you were outside, he'd have your ass. You'd be in so much trouble. Come here. I'll save you. Come on. Let's go. Sausage dog. Sausage dog. Come on. Inside. There you go. Bad dog. Time is 16:35 hours. Nice turn signals, Batman. Nice turn signals! Go! So we got a fire truck back. No turn signals.
Left. Thank you. Front. Look at my front.
All right. Left. That one works. Right. Nothing.
We can do a fire truck ride real quick around the block if they want.
Who wants fire truck ride?
Not down the hill. Stop. Great.
Up.
Yep. I don't think there's anyone. Oh, Jerry's left.
All aboard Batman, let's want to ride.
You want to ride fire truck?
Hold on.
Hang on a second, Batman.
Come on.
All right. Here. You can blog it for him.
Ready?
I'm not designed to fit this.
You gotta go all the way up. Okay?
I am in nowhere near.
Yep. I'm gonna sit here.
Okay.
Everyone's coming.
We're joining.
I know what.
We're joining today.
Oh, cool. I'm Chris. Welcome to the wheel.
Come on in. Right.
Cool. Hop on. Go up.
No. Right. Moose, hold
wait
that.
A second.
Alright.
We good?
You're gonna blog it.
No,
you're gonna
be
there.
Blogging it. You're gonna sit down. You're gonna like get up in there and
I'm going here.
Alright, cool.
I can't blog it.
Cool.
Oh, right here.
Alright, Batman, you're good.
Batman.
Got everybody in here.
You're wearing a Batman shirt. Yes, he's wearing a Batman shirt.
Cool.
You have to stay seated. On your bottom.
you give that to me because I want you to be able to hold on. All right, you guys have fun. That's today's captain's blog. See ya.
Take it back with me now.
You want to be a fire dog?
Sure.
You're the wrong color. It's a race thing.
My dog would love it.